Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Paathshala. And today's video is you have been waiting for. So today's video we are going to talk about the night eye and the rotary instruments. So nickel titanium is basically exotic material. So as the name suggests, the first one is going to be in the maximum quantity and the second one in the lesser quantity. So 55% nickel is present and 45% titanium is present in the night eye. Now if we compare these night eye with the stainless steel, this stainless steel is very hard, it's very rigid. So because, and we have already covered the anatomy of the root, and if we see the anatomy of the root and root canals, there is a distal inclination. And also these canals are not straight, most of the canals are curved, so these are some canals are tortuous. So like that, there are the different shapes of canal. The canal is not a straight line, even though we develop a straight line axis, but they are not straight line, right? So we need some instrument which can go inside and which doesn't break, which can go inside and take the shape of the canal, clean it and come back. So like that, we want something which can be like this. Suppose if the root is like this, right? So we want any instrument which can go inside and take little bend and clean it. But if we are putting a stainless steel file, then it is going to either stuck inside, break it, and or either it is going to not clean in this part of area. So we wanted some instrument which can take the shape of the canard. So these night eye wires are actually the shape, they have super elasticity. So they are elastic. Otherwise, if you look at a night eye wire, it looks straight. But when it goes into the canal, it takes the shape of the canal. It cleans the canal. We can take it back. So this is the main advantage of night eye wire over the stainless steel wire. So these are more flexible. These are 2 to 4 times more flexible as compared with the stainless steel wire. They're super elastic. They're fracture resistant. So it is like a super wire. But again, everything has some disadvantages. So night eye wire also had disadvantages. Their cutting efficiency is less if we compare with the stainless steel. Stainless steel is very hard. Of course, it is hard. And this night eye is flexible. It is soft. So this stainless steel has a good cutting efficiency. It has 1/2 to 1/3 more cutting efficiency if we compared with the night eye wire. And also these night eye wire, these are expensive, first of all. Second thing, they are more prone to wear. And also in case patient is having a nickel allergy. So we cannot use these night eye wires with a patient with a nickel allergy. So today's video, we are going to talk about a little more in detail about the night eye wire. How these night eye wire have super elasticity, has flexibility. So we are going to study about this. What makes this night eye wire these so flexible and it's super powerful. So we are going to read that. Also we are going to read in today's video the evolution of endodontic rotary. In that we are going to talk about the pro taper, which is the second generation. We are going to talk about the 5 generations of rotary shaping files. So we are going to pay little more focus and attention on the pro taper, because this is the file which mostly we use in India. We practice with the pro taper files. So we are going to talk about it in today's video. So without further ado, let's jump into it. So guys, before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon. That way you get a notification as soon as I release a video lecture talking about the rotary endodontics. Now we have night eye, which is our nickel and titanium. And nickel is 55% and titanium is 45%. Now this nickel titanium has super flexibility, as we all know. And this nickel titanium has a super elastic nature. That means, suppose if this is a file. Suppose this is a file. Now if we place this file in the curved canal and if we take it back, it is again going to come to the normal position. How this happens, how this magical process happens, so there is a science of course behind it. So this when the file is manufactured, now the original position of the file, can you see this original position of the file is a straight line, right? This is not a file, but I'm just giving you an example. So this straight line, when it is in a straight line, this is how it is manufactured. So this stage, this phase is known as austenite phase. This austenite phase is the stable phase. That means how much ever I am going to bend it, it is going to come back in its stable location. So this is the position, this is the phase at which the file is stable, at which the niti is stable. And this stable phase is known as the body centered position. Now can you see, body centered cube means this is the cube. I have made a 2D diagram for this. Can you see all the particles are arranged in a body centered? So that means they are in the center. So can you see these particles are basically in this cube. They are positioned in the center, right? But once you look at, this is how it is. This is the parent phase. This is the main phase. This is the stable phase. No matter how much you are going to bend it, it is going to come back at its BCC phase. So this phase is known as austenite phase. Now what happens once you cool it, right? Once you cool it, it is these particles who are arranged in the center. So these are going to go back like this, like this, like this. So they are going to go like this, like this, like this, like this. So can you see the earlier which was in the center, this is coming to in a hexagonal. So these are going like this, like this, like this, like this. But this is not a stable phase. These in which there is a hexagonal arrangement of the particles, this is the daughter phase, which is known as the martensite phase. This phase is when there is release of stress. So when I am applying the stresses, can you see, when applying the stress, it is changing its shape. So all the particles are actually moving like this, like this. So the, all the particles are moving like this. So this is like this, like this, like this, like this. But when it is in a stable position, it comes in a body centered. So these, all these particles with the green, they actually come in the center of the cube. That is why it is known as body centered. You don't have to remember this, because most of the students, they rattify this. Wo ratta marte hain ki BCC, pehle BCC, phir hexagonal. If you, once you look at the chemistry behind it, to agar koi bhi cheez stable jab hogi, wo center mein hogi. Anything, if it is stable, it will be, the particles will be in center, right? So this is the stable phase. And once these particles are unstable, that means the upper layer will go this side and the lower layer is going to go this side. So this is how the change is going to happen once we apply stresses. Once we apply stress, then it is going to convert in the martensite phase, which is our hexagonal phase, which is a weak phase. And once we release the stresses, can you see, I have bent it, and once I release the pressure, once I release the stress, it is going to come back again to its normal stable position, which is the austenite phase, which is our BCC. So it revert back again to the stable phase. This happens when we heat it. When we heat this nickel titanium, then it goes to a deformed martensite phase. Now this change in these shapes are known as our R phase. So it changes to this, changes to this, then again it changes. So we are going to talk about the R phase later on in detail. So you have to remember this. The stable one is the austenite phase, unstable one is the martensite phase. Austenite phase, stable one is when the particles are in the center. So this is body centered, because and cubic is because it is in a cube and all the particles are arranged in the center of the body. So these are the body centered cube. So this, because of this transformation happening, there is a flexibility, there is a shape memory. So when it is the stressor applied, there is a change in the shape, but when the stresses are released, then it comes back again to its original shape. This is the super elastic property. Now you all know why niti has super elastic property, why niti is so flexible, because there is a change in the phase from a strong stable phase, which is the austenite phase, to the martensite phase, which is a weak hexagonal shape. And then again, when the stresses are released, again it comes to the austenite phase. So this is how the whole process happens. And in niti, if you see, there is no permanent deformation. But if you look at the steel wire, if I'm going to bend a steel wire, it will just take a bend, it will deform permanently. So yeah, the stainless steel undergoes permanent deformation, but not the nickel titanium. It doesn't go, but there is a less cutting efficiency. As we all know, even niti has some drawbacks. So because it has less efficiency of cutting of the nickel titanium. So I hope that now you guys understand how it is super flexible, how it is super elastic. So guys, now talking about the pro taper which you all have been waiting for. So there are generations of rotary shaping files. We will talk about pro taper. So the first generation file is our passive cutting design. That means the like our K file, like our H files, there is a constant tapering. But that tapering is not 2% tapering. Like K file, H file, all of these files have 2% tapering. Tapering we have already covered. I am not going to talk about tapering right now. So, there is a constant tapering. All the file will have a constant number of tapers. So, every millimeter, there is going to be increase in a specific exact constant number of variable. And second generation on the other hand, which came later on, they have progressive tapering. Pro means progressive. Taper means tapering. So, there is a variable tapering. So, from D1, D0 to D3, okay, they have one tapering. And from D3 up to D16, there is another less tapering. So, this is about pro taper. So, the first, second generation, and also there was a passive cutting. If we talk about the edges, there the cutting edges are passive in first generation. There is a fixed tapering in first generation. And there are less chances of the separation layer. There are more chances of the fracture. And if you talk about second generation, which came later on, they have progressive tapering. And also, the second generation have positive rake angle. Rake angle we have already covered. So, if you haven't watched the rake angle video, then there is no use you are watching endo videos at all. Because rake angle, I have explained it more clearly. I hope that you are clear with the rake angles now. So, rake angle is positive. That means there is going to be more of cutting for second generation. But rake angle is negative for first generation. That means there is a scraping action for first generation, right? So this is the main differences between first generation and second generation, because pro taper is our second generation. So we should know what were the disadvantages earlier so that they are not in the pro taper, because we wanted sharp cutting efficiency which is lacking in the night eye files, right? So we wanted a sharp cutting efficiency for that. From second generation it had started coming, there are more chances of fracture, there is increased chances of separation, and also the cross section is very sharp. So if we look at the cross section of a pro taper instrument, actually they have, see, rake angle now you all know, right? So the radial angle is also more. So instead of like how it was in the K file, right? K rimmer is a triangular which is 60 degrees, so it is and obtuse angle for the pro taper file. So the pro taper files are more like a modified K type file. They resemble K type file, but because of this more angle they have more cutting efficiency. So this shape, this cross section of a pro taper file is a convex triangular shape. See, this is a triangle, but it is a convex triangle. So this is a convex triangular shape if we talk about of pro taper file. Basically, there are four scientists who gave this pro taper. And one of the important scientists is our Clifford Ruddle. So Ruddle is the important one. Also, we have three more scientists, John West, Perry McTon, and also Ben Johnson. But I don't remember all these scientists. This will be too much for you. Just remember, Clifford Ruddle, he gave this pro tapers. So, if we talk about the pro taper file, they have no radial lands. Radial land are the non-cutting side, right? So, this will be our radial. But there are no radial. There are sharp edges which are present. So, there is more of a cutting efficiency for our pro taper files. So, we are going to talk about the starting kit of the pro taper file. Pro taper file is the most widely used file in India, endodontic files. This one is. So, starter kit we have S1, SX. The first file is our SX. S1, S2. Then we have, these are the shaping files. So, as the name suggests, S means these are the shaping files. Then we have the finishing files. F1, F2, F3. These are the number of the files. Okay. Then this is the starter kit. If you want to buy separately, you can buy F4 and F5 also. I hope now you guys can see. F5. Okay. Now this SX file is the first file. This file has a diameter. First of all, let's talk about the color. Now these files basically have these golden these files have, these are the golden color files, right? So these golden color file have, this is the latch, suppose this is the latch, okay, and this one is a file, right? So this golden color end has rings. So these rings actually tells us about the instrument. So this S1 has, this has a purple color. This has purple color line. The S2 has white. So if you remember our K files, because we are going to talk about, this is a modified K file. So we are going back again to the K file. Now if you remember our 10 number file, which was our purple file, then we are going from pink, gray, purple, right? So these were the unicorns. So instead of gray here, we have orange color. So let's just write it from the red. I don't have the orange color. So SX is our orange color file. Then purple, then white. Then here goes the sequence. After white, we have yellow color. Then yellow, we have red color. Then after red, we have blue color, right? Then after blue is green. But because this kit finishes here, then these two files we have to buy separately. Then we are going to skip the green color. F4 we are going to write the black color. We are going to skip here, right? And after black comes the white, right? Again the sequence. Then white, then yellow. But we are again skipping one more. So after black, it was supposed to be white. But it is now, then it is now yellow, right? So this is the color coding. And SX file has, actually they don't have no rings. These files have no rings. And these are the shaping files. So if you want, you can finish up to the shaping also. And if you want, you can go for the finishing files also. So if we talk about the length, the orange color file is 19 millimeter. And the most important thing is diameter. Now this pro taper file have progressive diameter from D0 to D3. This is the 3 millimeter, right? And D16 is the 16 millimeter. So we are going to talk about the tip diameter only from D0 to D3. Because we don't want to go more into details. So for S0, SX it is, D0 is 0.19 millimeter. So you have to remember this. This you have to remember. And D0 for S1 file is 0.17 millimeter. And then from S2, now D0 is 0.20 millimeter. Okay. Now from here we are going to go according to the color coding. For yellow, if you remember, yellow color file. Remember the yellow color file. Then first we have to go back to the K file. So our 6 number file was our pink file. 8 number file was our gray file. 10 number file was our purple file, right? So instead of 10 number file, we have purple color, we have 17 number file, right? Then 15 number we had white color. Then we had, from here we are going to write. Then 20 number we had yellow color. Then 25 we had red color. Then 30 we had blue color. So like that we had. Now from the red color it is going to be similar. From the red it is 25. From the yellow it is 20. So I am going to write the same thing. From F files are same as the K files, the diameter. For D0 for F1 file, which is yellow color, is going to be 0.20 again. F2 file, D0 is going to be red color, 0.25 again. For blue file, D0, I am going to write blue file, 0.30. Are we clear up till now? Now that this kits end here, right? And we have skipped one color. Now, the next color would be, after blue, it is going to be 35 green, right? And 40 it is black, if you remember. Now black color is, we are going to write the same thing. So D0 for black it is 0.40, 40 number. And for yellow again 45 is white. And then again 50 is our yellow. So we are going to write according to the color codings. So D0 for yellow color F file is same as that of K files. Okay, 0.50. Now your question must be, ma'am, how would you differentiate between F1, F2, F3 and F4 and F5? See, from F file till the starter kit, only one rings are there. Only one ring is there. From S1, SX has no ring, right? S1, S2, F1, F2, F3. These all have one ring. The kit we are going to, the files we are going to buy separately has two rings. So these are a little bit different from what we talked about. So this is our pro taper file. I hope that you guys are clear. Now this tapering, this diameter is same. And tapering, if you can remember, only for F files you need to remember, because that is important. So for F file it is 7%, then 8%. For F1 it is 7%. For F2 it is 8%. For F3 it is 9%. For F4 it goes back again. Now the tapering was increasing, but it started decreasing again. So earlier it was 7, right? So we are going from 6. 6% for F4, and this is going to be decreasing. For F5 it is 5%. So tapering, which was increasing till F3, now from F4 and F5 tapering is decreasing. So this is easy to remember, not that difficult. Initially only up till the diameter, tip diameter for S files you have to remember. So it is, you have to skip 19, 17 and then go back to 20. 20 you can remember from this also. So 19 and 17 you have to just remember. So guys, talking about the generations of the rotary shaping files, the first generation, there are five generations, right? The first generation was the generation which came first in 1998, and they have passive cutting designs. Now you will be asking me how they have passive cutting design. We'll talk about it, don't worry about. And there is a fixed tapering. There is not a progressive tapering. Progressive tapering starts from the second generation onwards. So initially there was no progressive tapering, and these file used to stay in the canal itself, in the center of the canal. So suppose if this is a canal, then file is going to stay in the center. When the file is in the rotary instrument, they are in a fixed location. So they are in the center itself. And there are radial lands which are present. And this, we have already talked about the rake angle for this file is the negative rake angle. It is just doing the scraping action. The second generation, on the other hand, have positive rake angle. Positive rake angle means the cutting. Negative rake angle means the scraping action. So these have the scraping or the burnishing action. Now talking about the land area, if you see the profile, this is a file which has triple helical structure. So if you see this profile, so they have a land area. So can you see the land area? And this is the reason, because there are no sharp cutting edges. So because of the cutting edges are not sharp, because there is a land area, so they don't have that cutting efficiency. They have the passive cutting efficiency because they have radial lands present. Because of these lands, they are not cutting. See, if a knife is sharp, then it will cut nicely. If the knife is not sharp, this is blunt. So if a knife has, suppose the breadth of the knife is this much, then it is going to cut. If the knife has breadth of this, like this tip like this, then it is going to cut sharp. Then if a knife has like this, then it is going to cut not that sharp. And if a knife is like this, then it is not going to cut at all. This is the reason they have passive cutting design, because they have land area. Now I think all of you knows. These all are the examples of first generation's file. Okay, Hero 642 have more wider. They have more wider land area. So Hero 642, because as the name suggests, these file come in the tapering. 6% tapering, 4% tapering and 2% tapering. This is the reason the name is given, 642. So these tape, they are used with a contra-angle handpiece, with the slow speed handpiece, the latch type handpiece. Okay, so these with a speed of 300 to 600 RPM. And if you see, look at the structure, the cross section of this file now. This file is, guys, like this. So they have, can you see these wider radial areas? So the radial land area is actually very wide. So because of this wider land area, they have passive cutting design. They don't have good cutting. And if you see the Quantec, this pontic is also like this, the structure of pontic is also like this, double helical structure. And the quantic has 900 tips. This quantic, no, it used to do perforation. It used to do ledge formation. It used to do zip formation, elbows. So that is the reason there is a new series of quantic which came later on, was the quantic 2000. So this quantic 2000 series is specially designed by MX Pedal. And these are the new instrument. These instrument have, because it is forming the ledge. See, because this is forming the zip. So these files with the Quantec 2000, they had non-cutting tips. So this was preventing the zip action. So this is about the first generation. Also we have Hero 6. So if you see the cross section of Hero 642 file, then it has a triple helical cross section. So the cross section of this file is like this. 642 cross section has a triple helical H file, and it has, if we compare with the other file, it, can you see this has less land area. So this has more cutting efficiency. So this is our Hero 642. And if we look at the profile file, now profile file has land area. So this is our profile file. So guys, this one is our profile file with the triple helical structure, and this is the wider land area. And this one is our Hero 642 with the tapering 6%, 4%, 2%. And this is our Quanter with the double helical structure. Now coming to the second generation file, the second generation file have a good cutting efficiency. They have the active cutting edges. They have a positive rake angle. So the cutting efficiency is good, and also there is a progressive tapering which is present. So our Pro Taper series, the one which you use, the Pro Taper Gold files, the most commonly used file in India, but they are not that flexible. If you compare with the Blue series of Pro Taper, that is a really nice file to use, but it is a bit expensive. So these second generation have less number of file if we compared with the first generation. So the Pro Taper Universal is like our convex triangular. So this is the convex triangular structure cross section of our Pro Taper Universal file. And also we have M2 files in the second generation, which has the S shape surface area, S shape cross section. And in the second generation we also have K3 file, Hero Shapers. Basically Pro Tapers are our second generation rotary file. They are more aggressive, they are more effective, they have more effective cutting because of the positive rake angle. They don't have land area. Can you see the cutting edges? They're so sharp, they don't even have land area. So they have active cutting edges, and also they are less in number if we compare with the first generation. Now, but the drawback with this file is, most of you have, if you have used rotary, then most of you have used this Pro Taper Gold rotary, right? So the main problem is that there is a fatigue which is happening in these. Once you insert it in the curved canal, then they bend. So there is a bend because of the stresses. Because of the stresses, there is a cyclic or the torsional fatigue which is present in the Pro Taper. So in order to overcome that, we came up with a third generation files. So guys, there are fatigue which are occurring, tension and compression areas, and because of this the file is bending, file is distorting. So can you see the cyclic fatigue? It mostly happens when there is a dilacerated root, when there is a curved canal. So these are due to the simultaneous tension and the compression forces while it is happening, while the rotation of the file. So this is because of the cyclic fatigue, is due to the compression and the tension forces. The torsional fatigue is when it binds to the dentine, and when the file gets stuck to the dentinal walls. So when the file binds to the dentine and still the hand pieces continue to rotate. Now because of this binding of the file into the canal, so this file is somewhere stuck in this area. Now because of this, the file separates due to the binding of the file to the dentinal wall. And sometimes both of these happens. The also whenever there is, we have inserted and we have not removed the pulp properly, we have not expirated the pulp, and we are using these NITA instruments, and especially it happens with a gold file. So it happens with a Pro Taper file. That is the reason the third generation rotary and endo files have come up with three technologies. the MY technology, R phase technology, and CMY technology in order to reduce the cyclic and torsional fatigue. Now you will be asking, what is this technology? Already we are night eye, because a night eye we were already facing some issues. So there is some one more technology which came. This M stands for the mechanical. So there is a thermomechanical process which leads to the super flexibility. Now these pro taper are not super flexible, though they are flexible, but they are not super flexible. So there is a super flexibility, and there is increase in the flexibility, increase in the elasticity, and there is less cyclic fatigue, there is less chances of fracture, there is less chances of separation if we use this M wire, if we use this M wire technology. And the example for this M wire are the pro taper next, which we will talk about the fifth generation. So these are basically the technology of manufacturing these night eye. So the profile vortex and the GT series X are example of MY technology. R phases, if you remember, we have talked about initially when the BCC structure was converting to the rhomboid structure. So when there is from the between the, if you remember, there are twinned martensite and there was a deformed martensite. So in between these phases, when we manufacture the file, which is our rhomboidal, R represent the rhomboidal phase. So this is basically between the rhomboidal phases also, if you remember, martensite phase, there were two things, the weak rhomboidal phase, the twinned martensite, and the deformed martensite. So if the this is manufactured between the R phase, between these phases, there is a high flexibility which was observed, there was a high shape memory which was observed. So this technology is the R phase, which is the rhomboidal phase, is the intermittent phase between these two files. And the example for R type phase is our twisted files, so TF files and K3XF files are examples for R phase. Now coming to CM wire, these CM wire are actually, they are like awesome technology. I got stunned when I look at the technology. Now CM, as the name suggests, they have controlled memory. Controlled memory means you are inserting the file into the canal. And once the canal is, see, if the suppose this canal is curved and you are inserting this into the canal, this file is going to be like this. Until and unless you are autoclaving the file, this file is going to be in this shape itself. So no matter how many times you insert it, remove it, so it takes up the shape. So this is a special thermomechanical technology. The process is the special thermomechanical process which control the memory of night eye wire. So there is a controlled memory, as the name suggests, CM, controlled memory wire. And this controlled memory is removed after the autoclave, after autoclaving the file, and after the file come back from autoclave, it comes back to normal position. Otherwise, they are extremely flexible. That means they don't take up the original shape itself. So this is the example of CM wire, is our high flex CM. So is the example of CM wire. So this is the third generation which we talked about. Third generation was to reduce the cyclic as well as the torsional fatigue. But can you see one thing? Till now we have used this clockwise rotation. So in the hand instrument, if we talk about the K file, H file, all the file, we have all only studied the clockwise rotation of the file. And till now in the rotary also, till the third generation, we have used the clockwise rotation of the file. So where till now there was a concept of only clockwise rotation, now the concept came rotation versus reciprocation. So reciprocation, in which 150 degree was clockwise rotation, and immediately we do 30 degree of anti-clockwise rotation. So 150 degree clockwise and immediately 30 anti-clockwise, then 150 degree clockwise, then 130 degree, then the 30 degree anti-clockwise rotation. And the benefit of this was there was more of the removal of the debris. So there is more periapical extrusion as we compared with the continuous rotation which was seen. So this concept of reciprocation came in the fourth generation. So there is a clockwise as well as the anti-clockwise rotation which came. So it is a bi-directional movement. And there this concept of a one file came in the fourth generation. So we don't require multiple number of files. Now in the fourth generation, there is only one file which is doing all of the purpose. So the example of this is wave one, reciproc, So this Reciproc is also single file and it is made from the MY technology and it is used in the curved as well as in the narrow canal. They are high resistance to all the cyclic fatigue and they are very flexible actually. And also the self-adjusting file also came, the SAF files. Now coming to the fifth generation, there was one more concept came in the fifth generation. Of course, if a new generation has made, that means earlier, if you see the file was, if a file is rotating, if a file is working, then the file is working in the center, in its center. Now, how these files are working, fifth generation is, see, this is the center, right? Now, if the canal is curved, these files are moving in a wave-like motion. So, these are some nice designed wire, these files. So, they are not moving in the center. Basically, these files are moving in a wave-like motion and this is how these files are working. So, they have the offset design. That means they are not in the center. They are offset from the center. So, they are away from the center and the motion of these files is like the snake-like or the wave-like motion. So, these have a swaggering effects and the example for these, basically they travel the entire length of the file, so the entire length will be like this wave like motion. So the examples are the Pro Taper Next, which is the latest generation of the Pro Taper we have, and the Pro Taper Next is basically our parallelogram. The cross section is of Pro Taper Next is the parallelogram cross section, and or you can say the rectangular cross section. And Pro Taper Next is also made from the MY technology and they have greatest strength, and also the example are One Shape and the Revo X. Now latest generation are basically the one wire generation, one wire technology. We don't require multiple files. They are telling that only one file is doing all of the purpose. So this is about the rotary endodontics. I hope that I have made it little bit clear about the flexibility, how NITI does the purpose of flexibility, how these generation differs from each other and what make the other generation came because of the disadvantages, drawbacks of the previous generation. There is advancement of one more generation. So this is about the rotary endodontics. If you feel that you have learned something new today, then go ahead and hit the comment box and the like button, because this motivates me to put videos for you every day when you are staying at home and reading for your exams, because this helps me to help you with your career and knowledge while you stay at home with your family.